Hey guys, this is David Kwan, here to talk about the ending of Deus Ex, the ending moments actually. And that's really what I want to focus on in this video, simply because for most of the story, for most of Deus Ex, most of his story, I didn't really find it interesting. I was not invested or was attached to any of the story bits. You know, there's a couple of climaxes that happen, such as Paul's betrayal, and then meeting up with Paul Denton, you know, J.C. Denton's brother, and learning why he turned and why J.C. Denton must also betray the organization that he used to work for. It just kind of happens. I don't think it was executed all that well, but it's the story must keep moving on. You go to all these different areas, to all these levels, you meet new characters, and it just kind of trails along in a way. And I suppose it works. There's always a reason for why I'm at the place I'm at. Story works, but it's not something that really just gripped me and pulled me in. Some stories, and when the stories in games are exceptional, that is the effect of a story. It just pulls you in, and you want to keep playing it because you want to know what happens more, or because you really become attached to these characters that you're playing or that you're meeting. Deus Ex did not do that for me at all. The interesting moments, I think, was the ending, and one of the parts where I encountered this AI platform. And that happens in this hideout of the Illuminati member, Everett Morgan, I believe was his name. You end up in the hideout. You can explore. There's this bathroom. And in the bathroom, I threw a grenade, because I didn't want to use 4 lockpicks. That's a ridiculous amount of lockpicks, really. Just threw a grenade, boom, the mirrors broke open and the gate broke open. I went into the gate, found this data cube, and found the key. And that leads me to, I can use that to open this vault. And I get into that vault, and inside that vault is this AI prototype. And the dialogue that I had with that AI prototype is amazing. It's the prototype that was invented before, that Icarus and Daedalus is based off of. And Icarus is the AI that Yonako is using, and Daedalus is the AI that constantly supports J.C. Denton throughout the entire playthrough. Eventually, Icarus and Daedalus become hybrid AI because, J.C., the Illuminati, the main evil character, the main villain, tricks J.C. Denton into doing this, or whatever. It becomes a hybrid AI. What was the name of the hybrid AI? I kind of forgot. Shoot. But it is important, because that is really important to the ending of the game. So, anyway, I found that interesting. I think the ending is probably the most compelling moment of, in terms of storytelling, about that. In Deus Ex, and the way that the three endings of Deus Ex were cliche back then, and it's especially cliche now when a lot of games rip off of these kind of the concept of these endings. Deus Ex Human Revolution, for example, ripped off of this ending concept, which makes sense because it's a successor. Mass Effect 3 totally ripped off of these three ending concepts, but I think what makes Deus Ex 1's ending kind of memorable is it involves a lot. For to end up with one ending, you have to do something. You have to take different actions than you would if you wanted this ending. For example, for the synthesis ending, for joining with the AI and becoming the AI, you go through this. You unlock this secret. You unlock this door. You type in the code or the password, you hack this computer, you turn on the system, and then you backtrack to the AI, and you talk to the AI, and you merge with the AI. That's the ending, right? But you had to do that course of action. There's the ending to destroy the entire facility. In order to do that, you have to find specific points. Oh, no, never mind. You have to find this one radioactive, whatever, you have to go hack this computer, find this computer, and to get to it, you have to swim underneath these, you have to go to the experimental animal section, swim, You have to go past all these guards, find it, hack it, turn that down, and then backtrack all the way back to where you last found the aliens. And with that area, you put your hazmat suit on, and then there's toxic gas everywhere, and then you hack the systems that are inside the two computer terminals. And that's that ending. And then the last ending, becoming the Illuminati, is you go around and you shut down these four generators. And that way you can make the villain who's trying to become merged with the AI, you kill him. And then by killing him, you are now the New World Order. So really, to achieve the three different endings, you have to do three different things gameplay-wise. That is awesome. It's not just like choosing a dialogue option. It's not as easy as that. It's not just like Mass Effect 3. Mass Effect 3, to get to different endings, you either walk to that area with the blue light, and or you just jump off to the green light. So the blue light, you go to the blue light and you shoot something. You go to the green light and you jump off, or you go to the red light and you interact with it. That's really all that involves. You can choose your three endings. And with the DLC, you can shoot the little kid AI, and that's one ending there. It's not as easy as that. You really have to put in the effort. The hardest ending is to destroy the entire facility. So it's hard because there are so many enemies to get past, there's so many areas to get past to do that. And then becoming the Illuminati is also hard too, because there's four terminals that you have to shut down. It's really just easy. It's almost like the game maker's message is like, you want this ending, right? It's easy to do. You know, you just want to go to this area and then backtrack to this area. That's it. That's all you have to do. So it's really weird. All three endings are really tragic endings. Like, I don't know, like, none of them are happy endings. And I think that was the point. It's really powerful that you're given just these three choices. I could think of a fourth logical choice where it is a happy ending, but I can understand why that choice is not in this game, although I would have liked it. But yeah, you either blow up the facility, which completely destroys communication, like computer programs or anything, for the entire civilization. So the entire civilization goes back to the Dark Ages. That's one ending. There is no more AI, no more telephones, no more electricity. The entire world goes dark, technology-wise. That's one ending, which I think is interesting. And that's really to start over. You hit the reset button in civilization. Pretty interesting. Does it mean that you're still going to end up with an Illuminati or New World Order? Can't really say, but it's starting over. Second ending, and this is the most sinister ending. I guess this is kind of like, it's almost an evil ending. You know, the really, really bad ending, if you could see it that way. Because that ending is, you kill that one villain guy that I forgot the name of. You kill him, and you become like him. You become the new Illuminati. In a way, it's like, you know what's good for society, so you control society. You're behind the scenes Illuminati working with Morgan Everett, or Everett Morgan. Really, like, it's sinister because you now have become what you have been fighting all this time. That's why it's like an evil ending. You're controlling society. You're controlling the world and how it functions. Maybe it's, you know, you have good intentions, but you're still the master behind it all, and that's unethical in a way. So that's one ending, which I think is a really interesting ending that you can have. And the third ending is, of course, merging with the AI program that has the capacity to see everything in the world that's going on and to really control all the systems in the world. So again, you are controlling the world, but you become this super powerful being that is merged with the AI. And you still keep your character, so JC Denton can become a person that kind of is the eyes and ears of the AI program. That's interesting. So JC Denton pretty much becomes immortal. He becomes a god, in a way. A higher power, an artificial intelligence mixed with human emotions and human sense of justice. That is the third ending. It's pretty terrifying, actually. I feel like you know, maybe this is not, it's different from the Dark Age ending, and it's different from the Illuminati ending, because both of those things are keeping the status quo. You know, Dark Age, you just hit the reset button. You know, you just go back to the past where there's no technology. Illuminati, everything's the way it is, it's just that the players have changed. You kill the villain, but you become the villain himself. Status quo, right? Third ending, that it changes everything. There is now a god in society that controls everything and is omniscient. It's not omnipresent, but omniscient. Sees everything that goes on instantly because it's an AI program that is merged with the human body. Holy shit. And, you know, whatever it deems good for society, that's what's going to happen. So it's a benevolent god. It can be. It really depends on what kind of character J.C. Denton is. So it's a god. A god's will, a god's morality is going to be imposed on the society, because who are you to fight against a god who is so much more powerful than you? So in a way, me personally, I do feel like the third ending, synthesis ending, or the AI ending, I feel like that's the most terrifying ending. I can kind of consider that as the most evil ending. Because it's an immortal being. You don't know what's going to happen, what the AI will decide. And whatever the AI decides is what's going to happen with entire world, with entire societies. Like I said, the three endings that you get to choose, none of them are happy. None of them are good. But it's really interesting that these are the three choices that you get. I mentioned that if I could, I would have a fourth ending where it would be happy. And what I would do is have J.C. Denton kill the villain, but don't become the New World Order. Kill also Morgan Everett and destroy the World Order. Destroy the AI, but don't destroy the entire facility to turn it into Dark Ages. So that way, there is no more of this Illuminati deal, but you haven't just completely destroyed every single technology in the world, and you haven't set the reset button. It is still kind of a reset button, because it does pose, you know, there's still a possibility that some other New World Order can rise up out of this, but you haven't decided to become a New World Order itself, and you haven't actually just totally destroyed every technology in the world. That could have been a fourth happy ending, but again, I do understand why that's not there, because it kind of has no place in a game like Deus Ex, where it's really dark, and it does raise the notion of kind of AI controlling society, or the notion of conspiracy. Like, all the conspiracy theories are explained in this game. Aliens, Area 51, they're all here in this game, which is interesting how this game tries to kind of tie that in here. But those are my thoughts on the ending. I think, really, it makes sense why so many games in the future have ripped off the ending of Deus Ex. Because it's cliche, but it's so powerful in a way. You know, I'm going to have a video in which I talk about the endings of Mass Effect 3, and that's going to be pretty, you know, I think it's an interesting, even Mass Effect 3 can cause really interesting discussions, even though it's pretty much a carbon copy of the endings of Deus Ex. So those are my thoughts. Cheers.